For third place. It's not an official medal sport here, of course. The crowd, 55,235, just about 1,000 under the largest crowd in the history of baseball at Dodger Stadium. In wrestling, we had an American victory. Ed Banik, one of the Banik twins on the American team, defeated Ismail Temiz of Turkey in the 90-kilometer freestyle. Speaking of families, there are a lot of family stories in these Olympics. We have brothers, and we have twin brothers, and we have Pam McGee playing for the United States in this basketball game tonight. But that's a sister story that almost happened, but not quite, because here sitting in the stand is Paula McGee. She came so close. Dick Schaap tells us about it.
The 6'3 senior, number 11, Paula McGee. The 6'3 senior, number 30, Pam McGee.
They were a unit, the McGee twins, Paula and Pam. And if sometimes people couldn't tell them apart, it really didn't matter. They were inseparable. They were co-captains and co-stars in high school, both All-Americans on a two-time state championship team in Flint, Michigan. They were co-captains and co-stars in college, both All-Americans on a two-time NCAA championship team at the University of Southern California. Young, gifted, and 6'3", they even shared the cover of Jet, a post-championship trip to the White House, and so much more.
We were used to sharing the limelight. We were used to sharing a lot of awards. We always looked at each other as best friends.
They also shared a dream of representing the United States in the Olympic Games, a dream Paula could kid about 2 years ago when she pretended to be a TV reporter asking her All-American USC teammate Cheryl Miller about the McGee twins.
1984 Olympic team, what are your plans? You want to be on that team. How about the twins? You think that you three can make it, all three of you can be on that team?
I see no reason why we can't.
This spring, all three tried out for the Olympic team. And for the first time, Paula and Pam, even though they didn't quite realize it, were rivals. Cheryl Miller made the team. Pam McGee made the team. Paula McGee did not. Not strong enough, the coaches decided. Paula hurt, and Pam cried for her.
When you have to sit back and realize that a dream you've had for a long time is no longer attainable, that of course it hurts.
Paula did not hide her pain. She fled home to Michigan feeling sorry for herself. But then a few days ago, she decided to come back to California to watch the U.S. women's basketball team bid for the Olympic championship.
Coming back out, was it hard to make the decision to come back out to watch?
Yes. In a way, but I felt it was time to grow up, and I wanted to support my sister, and I wanted to see her take the gold.
Paula watched the Americans defeat Canada Sunday, watched Cheryl Miller dominate the team, its best player, its highest scorer. And Paula watched her sister Pam score 8 points and collect 4 rebounds. And after the game, she offered her sister advice.
Well, I told her I thought that she could be a lot quicker and that she didn't open up enough on defense and she didn't keep her eye on the ball.
Pam is trying to follow Paula's advice tonight as the heavily favored U.S. plays South Korea for the championship. Paula is in the stands at the Forum.
I'll be cheering like the rest of the Americans. I'll probably have a flag waving it, and I'll probably cry because I'll be there watching my sister and Cheryl and Lynette and everybody that I know. I'll be happy for them.
Well, we'll be checking back in on that basketball game, of course. The United States still with a comfortable lead in that gold medal game against Korea. Now, coming up very shortly is, well, this is the place where it's